Hello friends, welcome to the YouTube channel Pratik Sahas Maths Class. In this video session, we shall learn about logarithmic differentiation. When it is required, then whenever y is given in the following forms, for example, y is equal to x raised to x, or y is equal to sin x raised to x, or y is equal to x raised to sin x, you can see one special thing in all of them, that x and power is also in terms of x, base is also some function of x, and power is also some function of x. Whenever such type of functions are given to find out differentiation, we will use log function, because we know that log function has a beautiful property, that log x raised to k is equal to k into log x. It means power can be shifted front into the multiplication. So this property will be very helpful, very useful in solving the example whenever such type of functions are given and question is to find out dy by dx. These are some more examples: cos x raised to x raised to cos x, sin x raised to tan x. In all the examples, you can observe that base is some function of t as well as power is some function of t. In such cases, this method is useful. First example, find out dy by dx if y is equal to x raised to cos x. We know that it is very difficult to find out differentiation of this function. So first we shall take log function on both sides. So this is given to us, y is equal to x raised to cos x. Now taking log on both sides, we get log y is equal to log x raised to cos x. We are applying log function on both sides. Now using the property of log function, this power can be taken into the multiplication. So log y is equal to cos x into log x using this property. Now we shall differentiate with respect to x on both sides, because now we have get rid of this pattern that base is some function of x and power is also some function of x. In spite of that, right now we are having multiplication of two functions. So multiplication rule will be useful in this case. So let's differentiate with respect to x on both sides. Now here we have to apply chain rule, because first function is log and inside function is y, and we are differentiating with respect to x. So first of all, d by dx of log y is equal to d by dx of cos x into log x. So differentiation of log y is 1 upon y into differentiation of y is dy by dx. Here we need to apply multiplication rule. So first function as it is into differentiation of second function, plus second function as it is into differentiation of the first function. So differentiating this is as it is, d by dx of log x is 1 upon x, and differentiation of cos x is minus sin x. So we get this. Now going to the next slide, I will keep the last line as it is into the next one. So 1 upon y into dy by dx is equal to cos x into 1 upon x plus log x into minus sin x. Remember that we have to find out dy by dx. Differentiation process is over now. So our aim is just to make dy by dx subject of the equation. So we will proceed for the same. So simplifying, we get cos x upon x, and minus I am taking outside, minus log x into sin x. Since we need dy by dx to be subject of the equation, we need to shift this y on the opposite side, and it is in division here. So going to the opposite side, it will be into the multiplication. So dy by dx is equal to y into cos x upon x minus this one. Now originally this was given that y is equal to x raised to cos x. So already we have got dy by dx. Just one thing we need to do is substitute value of y from the given data. We are given that y is equal to x raised to cos x. So in place of y, we will substitute x raised to cos x. So dy by dx is equal to x raised to cos x into this one. This is the answer. So nothing is new here. We are applying the same thing that we have seen till now: multiplication rule, division rule, chain rule, and so on. Simplification, and finally we get the answer. Let's see one more example. Example number 2. Find out dy by dx if y is equal to sin x raised to 10x. So since base is function of x as well as power is also some function of x, first we will apply log function on both sides. So taking log on both sides, we get log y is equal to log sin x raised to 10x. Now using the property, beautiful property I will say, of log function, that power will be shifted into the multiplication. So log y is equal to this 10x is shifted here, 10x into log of sin x using this property. Now differentiating both sides with respect to x. So d by dx of log y is equal to d by dx of this. Here we'll apply chain rule and here multiplication rule will be applicable. So log y differentiation is 1 upon y into differentiation of y with respect to x is dy by dx. This is equal to first function as it is into differentiation of second function plus second function as it is into differentiation of first function. Still we have to find out derivative of log sin x and derivative of 10x. So 1 upon y into dy by dx as it is, 10x as it is. Here two functions are there, one function inside the other function. So chain rule will be applied. We know that differentiation of log is 1 upon x, log x is 1 upon x. So differentiation of log sin x is 1 upon sin x into differentiation of sin x is cos x plus log sin x as it is and derivative of 10x is sec square x. So when we are moving to the next slide, this last line will be as it is into the next one. So this was what we had got in the previous slide. It is saying, remember that we want to find out dy by dx. Differentiation process is over now. It means we have to simplify it and dy by dx should be subject of the equation. So let's try to simplify this. We know that 10x is equal to sin x upon cos x. So if I substitute 10x is equal to sin x upon cos x, let's see what happens. This is as it is. In place of 10x, I am writing sin x upon cos x. This is as it is. Everything else is same. Now here you can see that sin x and sin x will get cancelled. Similarly, cos x and cos x will get cancelled. So here we left with only 1. It means 1 upon y divided by dx is equal to 1 plus log sin x. This is 1 plus log sin x into sec square x. Now to make this subject of the equation, we will shift y to the opposite side. So dy by dx is equal to y into 1 plus log sin x raised into sec square x. Finally, we will substitute value of y from the data, original data given to us. Y is equal to sin x raised to 10x. So substituting y is equal to sin x raised to 10x, we get this as our final answer. So it's very simple. You can just do one more example or two more examples to get a better hand on this method. So in this video, we have discussed logarithmic differentiation. Stay tuned for more videos. Thank you.